happened after the agency in 1984, and then, you know, the business, the changes in the environment, the whole dynamics caused us to become a multifaceted, integrated marketing communication service provider, which is when we got into BTL, PR, events, media, all kind of specialist services. And then that thing bloomed, and then our next big step was that, you know, we were busy serving clients, and we asked ourselves a question: is it a good idea to sell our creative solutions, our thoughts, our ideas, our properties to our clients, or for a one-time fee, how much can they pay? They pay me 10 lakh, 5 lakh, 20 lakh, or should we try and follow the TCS model? Tara Consultancy Services those days had just launched Tally, and the story of Tally was very simple. You know, prior to Tally, everybody who came to a software solutions company, the solutions company understood the requirement just like us, like an agency, and created a customized solution for them. It gave them a solution, took the money, right? Now, this may have cost them 10 lakh, 20 lakh, whatever. So when Tata's realized that, listen, everybody is coming to them for an accounting solution, so they combined their entire brief and created a uniform product and called it Tally. And they launched Tally. And then they gave people an option to tweak Tally marginally to suit their individual requirements. Now, when they did that, that one Tally sold for maybe 10% of the total solution cost, but they sold hundreds of thousands of Tallies, right? So we said we should do something similar. So we tried with one or two of our clients, and we said to them that one was Reed and Taylor. You know, we gave them a line bond with the best. So we told them, okay, listen, we're not going to sell the line to you. You pay me 50 rupees every time you use the line. And the guy thought around for a bit, and he says, no, I pay you one time, how much? So we realized it's not going to work. We also tried with Hero Honda. In those days, it was just Hero Honda, it wasn't Hero. And we came up with a line called Desh Ki Dhadkan for them. We ran a big campaign, successful in those times. And we told them, okay, we don't want to sell the line to you. Every time you use it, pay me 50 bucks, 100 bucks, whatever. And they said, no, take lump sum, go to hell. I said, you can't believe it. It's my idea, it's my thing. It's up to me to decide whether I want to sell it or I want to lease it. But the way the industry was, nobody would take that idea. So we said, chalo, after I think we chhod dete, we'll try this elsewhere. Which is when we got into movies, content, events, and these kind of IPs. So we raised some capital, but we blew all of it up in the first year itself. The global economic meltdown hit us. So we lost a lot of money in the movies. And luckily, we survived, and, you know, we made some properties like Sunburn still come alive. As we speak today, I think we've gone around a complete circle. We have 33 audiences as of Jan, right? I think this whole thing, so we have broadly three sides to our business now. One is the whole Marcom piece, marketing communication, which was originally just an advertising agency, then became multifaceted, you know, whatever services. And this other side of our business is content, okay, which is your movies, television content, digital content, so on and so forth. And the third part, which was a part of live content, which is entertainment, which we made now live media. So now three big blocks. The entire Marcom piece we've now unified under Percept One. So we are now marketing ourselves as a Marcom solutions service provider, rather than an advertising agency, a PR agency, a digital agency, or a media agency. We're not. And that is, I think, we believe what the client needs, because the client is also fed up of dealing with multiple vendors. I mean, today, even if a client has a, you know, 2 crore, 10 crore budget, he needs to deal with some 20 agencies. So we're trying to offer all the services with one roof. So I think that's the future, and that's what we're focusing on doing. On the content side, we're a bit slow, but we're trying to rebuild Percept Pictures. We've got a couple of releases lined up, and we are going to go pretty big on the digital content, the short format content. And live entertainment business is repositioned as live media, and which is doing fine now. And we are, I won't say making a lot of money, but we are definitely in the black. So we're okay now. More consolidation, more focus, and more efficiency. That is all that we are focusing on. See, we grew too wild. We grew too wide. And I think I would say it's wrong to be ambitious. We certainly were ambitious, and we will continue to be. But I think we went a bit too thin. And a lot of these things that we tried to do couldn't have timed them better. But it's just unfortunate that they coincided with entire collapse in the so-called ecosystem. So the global economic meltdown 2008, 2009. And that's the time when we put all our life's earnings, plus all the money that we raised, and all the debt that we had, into the pipeline. And when our products were ready, there were no takers. So in one shot, we blew up a couple of hundred crores. Now that's tough. Now we struggled for a few crores. That time we blew up a few hundred crores in a matter of months. So it'll take us a little while to, you know, clean that out. I wouldn't say downsized. We have right-sized our organization. We are bringing focus on what we are doing, and it's okay. We've done this many times before, so we'll do it again.